วัสดีค่ะ Welcome to English in the News ถึงเวลามาเรียนภาษาอังกฤษจากข่าว BBC กันแล้วนะคะถ้าเกิดว่าคุณผู้ชมรู้จักใครที่กำลังเรียนภาษาอังกฤษอยู่เหมือนกันอย่าลืมแชร์บทเรียนของเราด้วยนะคะ And as usual I'm Claire and Sam is joining us from London Hello Sam
Hi Claire Welcome everyone This lesson is going to focus on the Amazon and the fires that are burning there and in other parts of South America
เมื่อปีที่แล้วเนี่ยเกิดไฟป่าที่บราซิลนะคะซึ่งทั่วโลกก็ต่างวิจารณ์รัฐบาลบราซิลว่าไม่พยายามแก้ปัญหาอย่างจริงจังค่ะพอมาปีนี้นะคะอเมริกาใต้กำลังเผชิญกับหนึ่งในไฟป่าที่ถือว่ารุนแรงที่สุดเท่าที่บันทึกมาค่ะ
Actually if you're interested we did a lesson on the Amazon fires last year and you can find that on our YouTube channel but for this lesson we thought we would start with a little quiz
เดี๋ยวเราจะมาชมรายงานกันนะคะเพื่อที่จะศึกษาคำศัพท์ที่น่าสนใจค่ะแต่ก่อนอื่นนะคะเรามาทดสอบความรู้เกี่ยวกับประเด็นนี้กันสักหน่อยนึงนะคะ I'm ready Sam
Okay great so I did not send Claire these questions before now so she really doesn't know what I'm about to ask her Claire there are three questions okay so here's question number one What's the name of Brazil's currentPresident, is it number one, Lula da Silva, number two, Dilma Rousseff, or number three, Jair Bolsonaro?
It's number three, Jair Bolsonaro.
Well done. Okay, question number two. Can you name three types of farms you can find in the Amazon? So what are three things that we grow in the Amazon?
Okay, coca, that was one of the examples. Coffee?
Good.
Okay, one more. Coffee.
Think fruit.
Bananas.
Yeah, very good. That's a great one. Okay, good. Yay, Claire. So cocoa, coffee, bananas. Other common ones are avocados and palms.Another big one is cattle, so cattle like cow farms. And these are all different ways that farmers in the Amazon make their livelihood. So livelihood is an important word here. Okay, and third question, Claire, is about vocabulary. Okay, so can you complete this sentence keeping the meaning the same? Okay, so I'll read you the sentence and then we'll talk about what we need to do. So the Amazon is burning.
Okay.
There are different ways to say burning in English. So another option is the Amazon is on
fire.
There you go. Yay. Okay. So the Amazon is burning. The Amazon is on fire. And there's maybe a third option. The Amazon is ah. And the word starts with ah.
Okay. Starts with ah.
The first syllable is ah.
พยางค์แรก ablaze.
Yay! Claire got it! Okay, very good. So, three ways of saying the same thing. The Amazon is burning, the Amazon is on fire, and the Amazon is ablaze. Well done, Claire. Okay, you can relax now. Okay, so now we have some other words that we want to make sure that you know before we watch the video, and they are canopy.
A canopy ก็คือร่มไม้ที่ปกคลุมหนาแน่นเหมือนเป็นหลังคานะคะ So an important word when you're talking about a jungle or a rainforest.
Yes, absolutely. And the other place we will go in the story are the wetlands, which are south of the Amazon.
A wetland ก็คือพื้นที่ชุ่มน้ำนั่นเองค่ะคราวนี้จะพูดถึงพื้นที่ชุ่มน้ำและป่าฝนซึ่งกำลังเผชิญกับภาวะแห้งแล้งด้วยค่ะ
Yes, and the word in English is a drought. And be careful with both the spelling and the pronunciation of this word, a drought.
ในขณะที่ดูรายงานก็พยายามสังเกตคำศัพท์เหล่านี้ไปด้วยนะคะไปติดตามท่อนแรกกันและจับใจความมาตอบคำถามต่อไปนี้ค่ะ
Are the fire bans working?
Above the canopy, unmissable signs that the Amazon is burning. But it's on the ground where the damage has been done. This virgin forest gone forever.
This is one of dozens of fires we've seen while driving through the forest today, and this is a specially protected area. Clearly, few people are paying attention to the fact there's a fire ban that's been put in place after the international outcry that we saw last year. But you wonder what hope there is when the government says that the fires don't even exist.
And the answer is no. ดูเหมือนว่าจะมีคนจำนวนไม่มากที่ใส่ใจคำสั่งห้ามจุดไฟเผาในที่โล่งนะคะไม่ว่าจะเป็นการเผาเศษไม้หรือขยะโดยคำสั่งนี้เนี่ยออกมาหลังจากที่มีคำวิจารณ์เรื่องไฟป่าเมื่อปีที่ผ่านมาค่ะ
Yes, there are many fires burning, even in the specially protected areas.
Specially แปลว่าเป็นพิเศษนะคะในข่าวนี้ใช้หมายถึงบริเวณเฉพาะในป่าฝนที่ได้รับการปกป้องเป็นพิเศษ Specially protected.
Yes, and don't confuse specially with especially. So specially means that something has a special use or purpose.So Claire and I make these lessons specially for you. Especially is used to talk about one thing over other things. So maybe you like all our lessons, but you especially like English in the News, or you especially like top tips, or you especially like build your English.
Just one thing, Sam, not everything.
Sorry, I know, I get very excited, but if you know someone who might enjoy these specially made lessons, especially because they're both in English and Thai, why not share our details with them?
Yes, tell them. Now, back to the story and the fact that specially protected areas are on fire.
Yes, the fires mean that virgin forest is gone forever.Virgin forest is talking about parts of the forest that are not used or touched or spoiled.
Virgin แปลได้มากกว่า1ความหมายนะคะจะใช้ในกรณีที่พูดถึงผู้ที่ยังไม่เคยมีเพศสัมพันธ์ก็ได้แต่ว่าในข่าวนี้เนี่ยใช้พูดถึงผืนป่าที่ยังสมบูรณ์ยังไม่ถูกทำลายค่ะ
Yes, and if virgin forest is burning or has burnt already,then the damage has been done. This expression means that there's no hope. You can't fix the problem because it's too late.
The damage has been done. แปลว่าความเสียหายนั้นเกิดขึ้นมาแล้วไม่สามารถกลับไปเปลี่ยนแปลงได้นะคะซึ่งเราจะเปลี่ยนกริยา be เป็น tense ไหนก็ได้แล้วแต่กรณีค่ะอย่างเช่นI apologize to Alice for my mistake, but it was too late. The damage had already been done.
Right, are you ready for the next question? Are the president and the government of Brazil trying to stop the fires?
For Raimundo, the fires are all too real. A cocoa producer.He shows me where the neighboring cattle farm burnt its land a few weeks ago and nearly destroyed his livelihood.
They set fire to the fields after the decree was introduced. I don't know why they didn't comply with the law. We often ask that. They must have special contacts. They know that they can commit the crimes and they aren't afraid of anything.
Small farmers like Raimundo face powerful opposition, though. With backing from the president, the agricultural lobby is more formidable than ever. And they keep burning. Yet Jair Bolsonaro remains defiant. He's slashed the budgets of Brazil's environmental agencies, instead putting the army in charge of protecting the rainforest. And earlier this month, he publicly called environmental NGOs.A cancer.
The president has problems with democracy. He can't deal with people that have different opinions. The cancer against the future of Brazil is the government action against the environment.
And the answer is no. ประธานาธิบดีของบราซิลเนี่ยสนับสนุนกลุ่มล็อบบี้ยิสต์ที่ต้องการเผาป่าเพื่อทำไร่ขนาดใหญ่นะคะนอกจากนี้แล้วผู้นำบราซิลยังเรียกกลุ่ม NGO ด้านสิ่งแวดล้อมว่าเป็นเหมือนเนื้อร้ายค่ะ
Yes, the president and the government slashed the budgets of Brazil's environmental agencies. So they cut or significantly reduced the amount of money that is given to agencies fighting to protect the environment.
To slash แปลว่าตัดนะคะหมายถึงการใช้มีดตัดก็ได้แต่ในข่าวนี้หมายถึงการตัดงบประมาณหรือ budget.
Yes, so what Claire is talking about there is quite common in English. Two words, in this case a verb and a noun, that appear together and they form a phrase. And there were other examples of these in the part of the video that we just watched. So, to comply with the law, to commit crimes, to face opposition. To comply with the law and to commit crimes are the opposite meaning of each other, but to face something is quite interesting.
To face something ในบริบทของข่าวนี้ก็คือการต้องรับมือกับบางอย่างนะคะนั่นก็คือการที่ชาวไร่ต้องรับมือกับกลุ่มล็อบบี้สต์ที่ได้รับการสนับสนุนจากประธานาธิบดีค่ะ
Now, are you ready to face the next question? Apart from farms, what else are the fires damaging?
It's not just the Amazon, though, that's burning. Further south, the world's largest wetlands, known as the Pantanal, is also ablaze, exacerbated by the worst drought for almost half a century. It's home to rare species like jaguars. Those who have survived are badly injured. So many more didn't even stand a chance. Jair Bolsonaro sees the Amazon as a cash cow, a way for Brazilians to prosper.But the way it's going, this is what the future will be. The slow death of the world's biggest forest. And time is running out for one of the most unique places on Earth. Katie Watson, BBC News, in the Amazon.
ไฟป่ายังทำลายพื้นที่ชุ่มน้ำทางตอนใต้ของอเมซอนด้วยนะคะซึ่งก็เป็นที่อยู่อาศัยของสัตว์ป่าหลายชนิดทำให้ตอนนี้สัตว์ป่าจำนวนมากได้รับผลกระทบจากไฟป่าตามไปด้วยค่ะ
Yes, many of the animals didn't even stand a chance. So to stand a chance means to have an opportunity to be successful. But here we are using the negative. So we are saying that they didn't have an opportunity to be successful.
To stand a chance แปลว่ามีโอกาสจะประสบความสำเร็จนะคะ So if you study hard and watch all of our videos, you stand a chance of becoming a fluent English speaker.
That's a lovely positive example. But why didn't the animals even stand a chance? Well, because of the fires, yes, but these have been exacerbated by a drought. To exacerbate means to make something that is already bad worse.
To exacerbate แปลว่าทำให้แย่ลงหรือทำให้ปัญหานั้นรุนแรงขึ้นนะคะ For example, the rush hour traffic in Bangkok is usually quite bad, and the rain exacerbates the problem.
That's another great example. Okay, so why don't we start to summarize the words and phrases that we've looked at together.
We heard that the fires are damaging specially protected areas of virgin forest.
Yes, and in these areas the damage has been done. The farmers trying to protect their land face opposition by many who do not comply with the law, but who commit crimes.
Their situation is exacerbated by the fact that the government has slashed the budget for environmental agencies.
And the damage, of course, doesn't just affect humans. Many animals, both in the Amazon and in the Pantanal, didn't even stand a chance.
We can't end the episode there. That was all really sad.
Yeah, you're right, Claire. That was really negative. So why don't we end by giving our audience a present because you made it to the end of the episode. If you subscribe to our YouTube channel or you follow us on Facebook, then we promise that we will give you a new lesson, a great present, almost every day.
That is so true. And here are two other presents for you. The link to our website and the link to the BBC News Thai website.
Yes, you can find more lessons and more news there. But that's it from us for now. Bye-bye, everyone.
Bye.